People have complained a lot about this car with one thing, which was the suspension. Okay, even compared to last week's video, it took me one take to do a recording. However, for this one, I'm now on my fourth recording because I'm trying to find the right setting. So I have to admit,
they were right. Oh my god, are you crazy?
Stupid lady. Can't even drive in this place. Okay, let's start this again.
Hey, it's your Nomad Consultant here, giving you another Nomad Ride review. Okay, this week is the Lexus CT200. This I always have time for, because it's a Lexus. So I'm going to be upfront, guys. This review won't be as impartial as other future reviews I'll be doing on cars, because I always have time for Lexus. Anyway, like always, the format is we'll do a quick overview of the car, a show round, the front, back, the inside, and then we'll go for a spin. All right, so let's go. Okay, guys, we start out with the overview from the outside, and like always, your boy Nomad, he likes to give any car that he reviews a nice clean with the car wash. So I do a nice inside outside of my local car wash. Have to give a shout out to them once I get to a certain number of viewers, but for now, I'll keep undercover for now. But yes, also while I'm on the subject, anyone who would like to donate their car for review, give me a shout. I'm more than happy to actually give a clean before I do it. So that's my incentive. Okay, let's start off with the front of the car. For those who like to know, this is some 17-inch tires right here. This is the premium model, so you're going to get a lot more toys. This is my A to B car at the moment, and I'll be honest, at first I wasn't a big fan of CT200. I considered it underpowered for my need, but actually for what it does, I'm more than happy. So yes, eventually I'll drive this for a while, then give it to the lovely wife for her to enjoy. So here is the side. Now, as you can see, it's a very good looking car, and Lexus over there, they've changed the shape, you know, a few changes here and there. So if you are those kind of people that want to follow with the latest trend and the latest car, by all means go for it. But to be honest, the car itself, for me, even today, it's a 9-year-old car, coming up to 9 soon, and it's still as sexy. I mean, that's my opinion. Now, this car, because it's premier, it has the reverse sensors. Make sure you guys get that. Yes, it's a small car, but look, you also get a camera as well. I recommend that sensor, it does help. So we come around from the outside, we come to the other side, to the driver's side. Again, it's got a slight tint on the rear window, pretty cool on that side, and not too dark, so you don't look too gangster as you go down the streets of wherever you live. But nice little touch, class, help for the sunshine. And there we go, that's the side. We're gonna go to the front, and this one has those daytime running lights, nice Lexus badge right there. And usually with Toyota Lexus, you'll kind of notice a bit of a trend if they have a bit of blue, that it is a hybrid. Because you have some cars, for example the Toyota Auris, where it's, you have the non-hybrid version and the hybrid version, so you can spot the difference from the little blue badge. All right, so that's the outside of the car. We're gonna go inside now. Before we do that, let's just show you a quick little trick. When you lock the car with your remote, the wings retract. I know for some people they don't give a, you know, damn about that. For me, it's a world of a difference. But the difference between this and other cars, which even brand new, some of them don't have it, and they try to show it. You put your hand in, as you can see, I'm about to put my hand in, and automatically it opens. Okay, that's a feature you gotta have if you're gonna go for the highest spec Lexus. Okay, now let's go for the inside. First of all, these buttons. Whenever I buy any Lexus car, because I do like my Lexus, I try to look for these ones. These are what they call memory. So for example, if you share the car, you have a one car in your policy, you know, not one car policy, that's insurance. You share one car in the family, and you know, if either you're taller or your wife is taller, you actually do your settings. And when you have to jump into the car, you press that button, the car actually remembers your setting. Now, We have all electric windows, lock as well, and at the same time there's a nice slot which I've tested out with my bottle and it does work. And then you have a few cool features here. Now if you notice in this review, unlike the Prius, I'm actually focusing on the toys because I actually bought this car for the toys. So this is the top of the range Lexus CT200. It has your wing mirrors there, auto retracting, the parking sensors, and then you have the steering wheel. Now this, I'm talking about, this is gold dust, okay? This is what they call the cruise control, but radar cruise control. So when I did my last trip to France, it was very comfortable. I can just put my speed limit and you don't have, you know, people having to slow down. The car will automatically slow down. But again, the problem with that, which I'll explain later on, you have jokers who always try to jump in and then therefore the car automatically slows down. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna go show the passenger side, but another cool feature, especially for those long distance, lumbar support. Okay, that honestly, it made my life so much easier, because you want to take a break, you press that button, it does it for you. Okay, now I'm gonna go into the rear side before we go full inside. Now if you notice, if you can watch my last video, yeah, and let's just say that the space from a Lexus CT200 and the Prius world apart. Okay, I mean, don't get me wrong, the kids were able to fit in the back no problem, but adults, you will actually, how would you say, not enjoy it as much for long trips. But saying that though, if you can see here, once the camera focus, actually it only has a very low, there's no huge hump, so therefore at least the person in the middle can actually enjoy. As you can see, this is all leather, nice and clean. Okay, so that's the side. It has also decent door opening, so, but you do need to be careful when you're in those car parks, because people do like the ding, so make sure when you open them you don't open, how would you say, too hard. Now let's go back to the boot. Little button, even if the car is locked, put your hand there, it opens. Okay, as you can see, big difference when it comes to the boot size. The Prius can go on for days. This one can fit a comfortable, how would you say, suitcase. But at the same time, if you have more than one suitcase, honestly, it's a case of playing Tetris. That's what I kind of found on my last trip. So there's the boot. As you can see, third brake light, nice antenna for the radio. Okay, now we're gonna go inside. Okay guys, we're now inside and I wanted to give you a quick overview on the inside, how the car starts and everything. So before I do that, show you the radio. This one is the Mark Levison. Anyone who buys an Lexus, if you see a Mark Levison, it's the equivalent of Bose for a certain car manufacturer. I think Mercedes, I forgot what it was, Mercedes one called, but I think that car, isn't it? Yeah, it'll come back to me anyway. Okay guys, so we are now inside of the car. We're doing a quick overview so you can see how the car starts. And one thing I didn't show you was the fact that it has your standard and USB as well as your normal socket charger, a place to put your phone in. I do have to admit, and as phones got bigger, you might probably need to buy a phone stand from Amazon or eBay or whatever you guys normally buy it from. But yeah, main thing, Mark Levison. Any car you buy from Lexus, if you have the Mark Levison, you will enjoy some premium sound. And I'll try and play some music. I don't want to violate YouTube's policy, but I'll see if I can play some, I don't know, classical music, so I think that should be okay. But anyway, just for you to, you know, check out the sound, you don't need to spend a big bass box or any kind of amp. It has everything in there. As you can see, it's got digital radio, this model. So let's start off by first of all switching the car on. Car comes on, the ready sign comes on, the screen automatically pops out. And yes, people say it's not big enough, but come on, what do we need it for? For myself, I only use it just simply. So yeah, basically, I just use it to see what radio station I'm at, what kind of music is playing. Sometimes I do use the map. So my recent trip to France, it was good to compare what Google was saying compared to what the car. Always use Google because Google has the latest information. The car map, you probably need to update it by some SD software update or something along those lines. But anyway, back to the car. As you can see here, this is the dashboard you get. If you choose the button for sport, even though you really need it because you're trying to enjoy the good old an MPG, basically it turns to red and then it turns here into a rev counter. So that's basically it. Then you have as well the settings, which is similar to the Toyota Auris. At the moment, I've been a bit naughty, I mean, with the AC, and this car's got AC, so unlike the last review where you saw me sweating like a pig, at least here I'm chilling like a villain. So as a result, I get to enjoy the AC on this car. But yeah, there's my average MPG. What else is there to show you? Like I said, the Bluetooth settings is all there, your cruise control. But, and I think one thing I wanted to show you was the coupe. So right now, you can't really see, but I'm sitting really low. I put the seat all the way back, so that's why I was explaining about how the car is good for all types of people, tall and short. So, press my one. This is where I say, okay, you know what? I need to start driving. Press that button, and automatically the car does move. The wing mirror does the setting it needs to do, and everything's good to go. So that's a cool thing I like about it, because sometimes if you do share your car, I don't do that often, but I have to, but that's a good feature to have. And then also another cool thing I like is that when you put reverse, the wing mirror goes down, helping you to reverse so you don't scratch your nice alloy wheels. Reverse light comes on, as well as the reverse camera and then the reverse sensor. So all in all, best package. But then you still have some people who will still hit something. But that's life. Anyway, back to the engine just now kicked in. And so now, another thing I forgot to mention, heated seats, rarely be used. Winter, we'll see how that goes, but at the moment now, it's rarely used. And yeah, because the how would you say, the gearbox is here, it makes everything much easier from a, you know, layout perspective. So that's basically it, a good summary. Now, final thing is, before I test out the sound, here's the mouse. I see some guys on reviewing, when they review, they hate it. And I'm thinking to myself, look, let's be honest. It does a job and it saves you from having to use both hands. So I think it's safe. And for people who know how to use a mouse, yeah, it's not that difficult. The good thing I like about it, so here I am, I'm now going back, I'm choosing my settings. And then I get to choose what I need to do all on my left hand. But the good thing is as well, people sitting next to you can also manage, so you don't actually have to do it. It's easy access. So that's basically it. Final thing is the music. Since I'm raving about Mark Levinson, let's see how it sounds. This is classical music, so it should be okay. This is, of course, it's playing quiet music, but let's just go max. Oops, I'm changing that. Let's go back. Here we go. Now, it goes all the way up to 60, so I'll try and stop at 45. Okay, so that covers it on that side. We'll now take it for a nice spin, and then you guys can enjoy the ride. Okay guys, it's time for a test drive in this nice Lexus CT200. Put the car in drive and automatically it locks the car. That's a cool feature I like. Anyway, so let's start off with the bad points about this Lexus. One of the biggest complaints a lot of people have is about the suspension. They go, oh, it's too hard. It's trying to be, you know, sport, and especially for Lexus owners, this is the car that they got used to. This is the car that they got used to for having soft suspension, best chairs. Chairs are really good because I do love the lumbar support. But the fact is, I have to agree, and this is the reason why I didn't go for the F Sport model, because it was even more stiffer suspension. I went for the SCL version with all the toys, because I do like my toys, as you'll notice in future car reviews. One of the things I look in a car is actually what toys comes with it. And I get annoyed with stingy manufacturers.
basically, I'm gonna mention a few, like Vauxhall, who give you a million and one choices when you just want a car with the basics. Anyway, as you can probably see here, I've decided to come to a car park because every time I try to use with my budget camera and camera holder, it kept on shaking. So I don't want to annoy my viewers with the shaking camera. At least give some element of professionalism. So yes, you're gonna see a lot of repeat and background. Anyway, back to the car review. So yes, the biggest issue with the Lexus CT200 is the suspension. A lot of people don't like it, and I never noticed it until I started filming that it does shake a bit, but as a car, it does the job. So you don't notice it when you're driving A to B. Of course, when I compare it to other Lexus I've owned, like the GS450, yes, I do notice the difference. But if you think about it, the Lexus CT200 was, as Lexus call it, the compact tourer, which is basically a Lexus way of saying a premium hatchback, okay, was designed to attract the younger generation. Lexus, whether we like it or not, has always been known for the older generation. However, and even some people have actually, you know, made fun of it, just call it a rebadged Toyota. But it's a world apart from a Toyota. Yes, Toyota have the toys and everything, but Lexus comes with this element of luxury that I enjoy. Hence the reason why I'm a big fan of Lexus. But yeah, back to the suspension part, I have to agree, yes, it's not a car that's for everyone, cup of tea. But let's be honest, we are not white van drivers driving every day. We just want a car that takes us A to B, and the Lexus does that and plenty. So I'm okay with the fact that it doesn't have soft suspension. But if you, and this is why people get annoyed with the F-Sport, because you have all that nice suspension, you know, sport wise and it looks apart, but it still has the same engine. Hence the reason why I wasn't too fussed. Saying that though, if I did have to go for the IS300, which is the car I wanted, I would go for the F-Sport because it just looks sexier. Anyway, back to the other bad point about the Lexus. I have to admit, compared to the Prius I reviewed last week, leg space is not that great. And for kids it's alright, but if you have adults and they like to stretch their legs, they will find it difficult in the back. And if you're the driver, you find with kids sometimes the legs just kick you in the back and you just get annoyed. So yeah, that's one issue. Another bad issue. What else is there? I think except for those 2 points, you'll be hard pressed to find any other faults with the Lexus. It comes with all the toys. Now the good points is, like, one of the biggest plus for me was the fact that if you thought I was loving the £10 road tax on the Toyota Prius, with this car, when it comes to renewal, you pay only zero. I mean, the fact it's a newer car with a low emission, when you get the car renewed, you basically are actually having to pay nothing for tax, which is great. But at the same time, this is why probably the government decided to start punishing motorists, because they see us as a cash cow. And any car from 2017, you have to pay a tax, road tax, which is annoying, because you first of all tell us, oh, diesel is the way forward, and you give incentive, and then now you're saying, oh, electric vehicle and hybrids, and we do that. So unfortunately, but anyway, let me stop there. That's politics. We're back to car reviewing. So yeah, the Lexus CT200, it's a lot more expensive than the Toyota Prius, but you're getting a Lexus, and with some people, that's all they want. They want that badge. They want the ability to actually say, I own a Lexus. And let's be honest as well, if you look at the other cars for the 4x4, you're paying a lot of money, so to have that badge is great. This is why most of the Lexus I've owned in the past have always been a lot older, but I decided to treat myself to a newer vehicle in order to enjoy all of the benefits and the toys that comes with it. So that's one thing. What are the good thing about it? The toys. I showed you earlier in the video how much toys we get with this car. I love the fact that you get leather, heated seats, and also power wise it does the job. So the Toyota Prius we actually drove last week, that was a 1.5, which is still okay, nippy, it does a job. But this is the 1.8, so it has a bit more power and you can kind of feel it, especially when you put it in sport mode. But at the same time, you're not being punished for that extra power, because like I kind of felt like it claims 70 mpg and I'm thinking, yeah, right, but with myself with a heavy foot, I'm getting 50 plus. That kind of shows you this car is really good on mpg wise. And what else is there about this car? I mean, if you were to look at it from a competition perspective, think of the Toyota Prius as a camel. It's a good workhorse, it can go on for years, and the CT200 is like an Arabian horse. It has the looks. You can walk up to the car park and proud when you press that button, and all the cool features that come with it. And the funny thing about it is that when it came out, the amount of motorist journalists that was making fun of it, saying how rubbish it was, and it's just a poor man Mercedes and all that. But actually, people voted with their wallet, and this is one of Lexus' biggest seller. And for myself, the thing that attracted me to it, because I did like the IS300, because I like the extra horsepower, is the budget. You can pick up some good cars. I mean, they start off about £6,000 to £7,000 if you check on Auto Trader. But actually, those are the high mileage one. And even if you get yourself a high mileage one, they still last a lot longer than other cars in the same year. So the way I look at it, for a low mileage one, you're looking about £7,000, probably £9,000 will get you. But also you have to remember there are so many models, and Lexus are starting to copy some of the other manufacturers. Before, it used to be a case of all or nothing. So they would give you any of the cars they sell, comes with all the toys, and it's just a few extra. But slowly they're starting to copy, because it's all about money in this day and age. But when it comes to customer service, guys, I thought the Americans were overdoing it with this whole level of like, oh, we love Lexus, but it's here in the UK that customer service is second to none. And I've had to take us to a dealership, so shout out to Milton Keynes. They took care of me as if they've known me and my whole family when I've just met them for the first time. So customer service is key for them, and this is probably why people come back to them time and time again. So in respect to that, Lexus, you know, they actually have a great, you know, reputation for that. What else is there to talk about this car? I took it for a trip to France and back. I've only filled up the tank, and this is me going all the way to Paris, all the way back. And I could have still risked it with probably a tank and a half, but I don't like to take that kind of risk with the family. It's a great car, and he actually is something that a lot of people, if they want to have a great hybrid with a reputation, I would go for the Lexus CT200. So, especially to my viewers who live in London, where every day you're being choked to death with taxes and congestion charges and ULEZ, the whole ultra, you know, low emission, a CT200 is the best choice for you. I mean, come on, speed of 20 miles an hour, and we in Milton Keynes get to enjoy national speed. So why do you need to have a sports car? Get yourself a hybrid, especially a cool hybrid like the Lexus. There are other hybrids out there, Toyota, Honda, Hyundai and all that, but the Lexus kind of stands out. So of course I am being a bit biased here, but if you remember when this car first launched, Kylie Minogue, she was the model for this. So she was the face for Lexus and the whole quiet revolution. Well, anyway, that kind of sums it up on my side. Hope you've enjoyed this review. Hope you've enjoyed my own unbiased yeah, right, when it comes to Lexus. But until the next time, guys, till the next car, which won't be a hybrid, I'm telling you right now, because I've actually pushed my luck with hybrids, and you guys are probably fed up of hybrids by now. It's gonna be a non-hybrid. Take care.